So this is my high quality vlog for today. We are at Denny's. It is 4 o'clock in the afternoon. There's Crystal eating her I don't know what it is.
It's food.
And there's Heather eating her it's food. I'm not hungry, so I got a salad. Today has been a very, very slow day. We didn't go to bed till after 2, I want to say sometimes even closer to 3.
I have no clue what time we went to bed. I just thought it was late. We just kind of
all I know is I took my sleeping pill and I sat down on the bed and I was just like reading random stuff online and I started falling asleep, so I just...
Well, you and I were in a conversation, I think. And then we both just kind of stopped.
Yeah. I think that was true.
We were laying there talking and then all of a sudden I think we just...
Yeah. We both gave up.
Yep.
So anyways, we today were going to go to Trader Joe's is what our plan was. Trader Joe's is right across behind this wall.
You can see the sign saying Trader Joe's.
It's not right now.
On the other side of the wall.
Yeah. Actually, you can see Trader Joe's on the other side of the wall, not just the sign.
Yeah.
So, our hotel. On the website, it said they had shuttle service to the mall.
And other local attractions.
The airport and other local attractions. To me, across the highway would fall under, well, not necessarily an attraction, but at least
but it's local.
A local.
It's literally 5 minutes away.
Mm-hmm. A local drive. So last night we asked our shuttle driver that brought us back from the mall about it, and he's like, well, technically we're only supposed to do the mall and the airport. But if I'm working tomorrow, I would do it and I'm not doing anything. He goes, it's up to the driver. So, okay. We're still planning on going to Trader Joe's. We get up to the lobby and we talk to the person at the front desk. The person at the front desk doesn't say no, just says that the driver is currently gone, mm-hmm. and to discuss it with her when she gets back. So we wait in the lobby for half an hour. Finally, the shuttle shows up. We go outside and now we can't find the shuttle driver. She is sitting on the benches in the front of the lobby, talking on her cell phone, having a conversation with, it sounded like a friend. And she finally realizes we're standing there and she asks, well, do you guys need to go? And we say Trader Joe's. She's like, technically, I'm not supposed to be doing this. What did the front desk say? And we're like, we were told to ask you. And she goes, oh, okay. Well, I really don't care, but I want to go in to double check to make sure this is okay. She walks into the lobby. We're still waiting outside by the shuttle.
The shuttle's still sitting there right now.
It has not moved, and it's like an hour later now. Because, yeah.
That's our shuttle right over there.
I don't know if you can necessarily see it with the glare if I zoom in. Okay, now you can see it. See that van right there? That is our shuttle. It's still sitting there, an hour later. So anyways, we're still standing outside waiting for her to go in to check. All of a sudden, the one front desk lady and it looked like a housekeeper walk out. They're done with their shifts, okay? And they're like, well, are you waiting for the shuttle? Where are you going? And we're like, we were wanting to go to Trader Joe's. The shuttle driver went in to ask if it was okay. And she straight out, well, no, that's not okay. We don't do this. We only go to the mall and the airport. That's it. And then she goes, if you want to go over to Trader Joe's, you can walk over there. And Heather looks at her and she's like, that is across the highway. And she's like, well, you can walk there. And the housekeeper that was standing there, she's like, no, they can't. And then she goes, well, okay, whatever, take an Uber. So just out of curiosity, we looked it up. To take an Uber across the highway.
A 5 minute drive.
Less than a, it would take longer for the Uber driver to get to our hotel than it would be to take us over there. was $8. So that's $16 to drive across the street and back.
And we're only probably gonna buy like a couple of things.
Yeah, that was our plan. So, and even like we...
Yeah, it's probably gonna cost more to take an Uber there than what I was gonna spend money on there.
Then, well, there's a Marshalls over there, so we were like, you know what, if they had to go like on an airport run or a mall run and drop us off on the way back, you know, we'd go over there, we might go over to Marshalls, look around there too, just to kill time, and then call them, and if they had to come back around to pick us up, if they had to go do a run, we got it, we understood that.
Because it's exactly in the path that they need to go.
Yeah, when you get off the highway.
To get to and from the airport and the,
yeah, the mall.
You go right by it.
Yeah, you could literally pass it.
So, they, we're still waiting outside for her to go outside. So, this one, these two workers go out, they walk off, they go to their vehicles. About 5 to 10 minutes later, the second front desk lady walks out and just says, bye, have a good day. Doesn't say anything. We're still waiting for another 5 to 10 minutes for the driver to come back to say yes or no. And at that point, Heather was getting shaky because she was so hungry. I really wasn't hungry, so not much mattered to me. Crystal's hungry, and we're like, yeah. Denny's is right there. We're just gonna go eat. And it's just, it's frustrating because even if she walked back out and said, sorry guys, they said no. We could have walked over to Denny's 15 minutes earlier. As well as there's a strip mall not far down the highway that used to have the Babies R Us in it. And it's got a Burlington, and it has an Land's End that I kind of wanted to go to. It would be the same price to drive further,
yeah,
to that strip mall and back as it would be to go to Trader Joe's across the highway.
Yeah.
And I get Uber probably has to have
we
a minimal
fee. We can actually see Trader Joe's from our hotel room.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We can see the building and the sign from our room when we open the window. And yet, they can't take us there. We're supposed to spend $16 to drive across the street. And honestly, like we were talking like that, Burlington and like where the Land's End are, if Babies R Us was still open, we would have spent that $16 to drive over there. And there was a restaurant over there, so we probably could have done it later and ate there,
yeah,
and then come back. But yeah. But none of us really want to spend $16 to drive to Burlington tonight. Because mm-hmm. I don't plan on really buying anything at Burlington. I have a Burlington.
We don't.
Yeah, you're in the middle of nowhere.
I know.
And you're just in Canada. You don't even have Target.
But it's not a big deal. I can take an early Burlington.
But regardless, it's, if Babies R Us would have been there, like take,
yeah,
the dolls,
yeah,
and go to Babies R Us and have fun, yeah, at Babies R Us. And we looked up where Bye Bye Baby was, and this makes absolutely no sense to Heather.
No, it doesn't.
Or myself. Bye Bye Baby is literally on the St. Paul side of Minneapolis, St. Paul. And it's like, there's like a few shopping places around it, but not many. And that's the only Bye Bye Baby in the Minneapolis suburb area. So I will pick up this lovely, boring vlog later when we get back to the hotel. So we made it to Trader Joe's. We got back to the hotel from eating.
Actually, no, it should be like this, Vanna White.
So we got back to the hotel from eating, and the driver was just sitting, watching TV and eating. And
yeah, I forgot to mention that part of my video.
So we're like, what the heck? So we go to our room, and we notice there was a different person at the front desk, and it was the person that we've had really good experiences with since we got here. So Heather had to go use the computer from the hotel, and Crystal and I were in the room. I'm like, Crystal, instead of walking down there and asking him, how about we call and ask. So Crystal called, and he put her on hold, and I'm assuming for the amount of time he was checking someone in. And he comes back, and he's like, yeah, sure, we can take you to Trader Joe's. So we walk down there, and at the point that we're getting our bags to walk down there, we open our, or we close our drapes, and we notice the driver is walking the opposite direction away from everything.
Yeah, like basically leaving the hotel.
And we're like, what the heck? So we get down there, and he is like walking around the lobby trying to find her. And eventually she comes back, and he tells her to take us to Trader Joe's. And she's kind of like all confused, like,
yeah,
about this. And I mean, she did apologize, and it was kind of an attitude she said when he said to bring us, but as we were driving over here, she got more friendly.
Yeah.
But so we made it to Trader Joe's. Now we are in Marshall's. Yeah, all three of us are nuts.
Okay, well, I am the one to blame for the bibs because I found the llama bibs.
Llama.
I say llama.
You say llama.
Let's call the whole thing off. Okay, and then this one here is Nicole's fault.
Yeah, sure. Okay. So, yeah, we're just looking around.
Okay. See, like, I can't even. You're gonna have to cut that out.
Okay.
So then we're looking at squishies.
How do people find those things satisfying?
That is weird. That just feels weird.
Squish it all the way, though. Like,
all the way?
Yeah. Apparently, I don't understand the world of squishies. Let's see if Crystal understands it.
He sent me a picture.
It feels like memory foam or something. It's
and would
weird.
You pay $8 for a piece of memory foam that is like a neon ice cream cone? Crystal?
No. No, I would not pay $8 for a squishy ice cream cone. This reminds me of those rattles we made when I was at your place. So we had this craft, I found this craft idea online on how to make these baby rattles out of baby socks. So you take like this old empty pill bottle, fill it with beans, wrap it in like a polyfill kind of thing, stuff it into a baby sock and tie it off in a knot. So then you had like this big round thing at the end.
Yeah, I think we had oversized pill bottles though.
And then, you know, this the long part from the knot just hang. So you're just like, flinging these things around, and I'm thinking, you're gonna give this to a baby, and they can like smack people over the head with this. So that's what happened at the last meetup, and that's what this reminds me of. But I'm sure that Nicole is thinking of something else.
Crystal. Get it.
Soft and fluffy.
But we have so many, like, our...
You have llama blankets? You don't have a bunch of llama blankets.
And it's pink, your favorite color.
I know, but...
And it's so soft.
I have nowhere to put it.
Tell Alex.
Because he just brought home this honking huge blanket from his that used to belong to his grandma that looks like it's from the 30s and like it's got like I don't know prints that you would see on someone's couch in the 50s.
Well, it will disappear and the llamas will reappear.
When he brought that thing home, I was like, what is that? It's my grandma's blanket. I wanted to keep it. Do you know he hasn't used it since he brought it home? It's just sat there in our bedroom. Hasn't used it.
Once again, that will disappear.
I know.
Or tell Alex he can sleep on the floor with his blanket. Will you get the bed? With your blanket.
I don't know. I'll think about it as we peruse.
We're in the home goods section of Marshall's and I'm screwed. Because we have found not only these might be alpacas. They're a little bit smaller.
Okay.
We found some alpacas. some llama towels.
And?
More llama towels. And bees.
Yep.
And I already have the extender on my suitcase out to come here.
Yeah, but you had all of our stuff in there too, which is all.
And you haven't bought nearly as much as we have.
That's true.
You need to buy now.
See?
Yes. You know, she's been influencing us to buy.
Yes.
You do realize this, right?
Yes.
It's been all about, Heather, go ahead and buy it. Crystal, go get those llama blankets. Go get them.
Yeah.
So,
and she's barely bought anything.
Yeah. So I think you need some towels.
Do you want to make the phone call to my husband about the towels?
Yes, I do.
Okay, call him.
She's gonna do it. She's gonna do it.
I don't know if I have Brian's number on my phone right
now. This is hilarious.
Give me his number.
Awkward to drink out of. Are you filming me filming?
Yes, I am.
And I should take pictures of you.
I am not filming while you're filming.
I just want to film you. You filming.
What?
And then Heather's going to
take a picture of you filming while she filming you filming.
Oh my god.
Heather, there's a Harry Potter one too.
As I was saying, I have this mug, but it's a monkey. And it has like this little bump that comes up here because it's supposed to be his hair, and that is the most awkward thing to drink out of because there's like this bump in it. And so that's my story.
The other point is you trying to film with everything you're carrying.
Oh, that's why you're filming me.
When you were trying to get your camera out.
Exception.
The point of you trying to get your camera out to film the cup.
Did you film me trying to get my camera
out? No, I didn't have mine out.
Oh.
But the fact that you're like shifting everything around.
Oh my gosh.
So we finally were able to do this. Heather and I changed our dolls last night. Crystal did her box opening this evening. So now we were able to do it. So, going to the American Girl store, Heather brought Caroline. Crystal got Nameless.
Nameless.
And I brought my daughter's Emma Maya. And Heather got Caroline's hair done. And then Crystal just got her doll, so she didn't go to the, or she got her ears pierced at the salon. And then Emma Maya got hearing aids in both ears because my daughter is convinced that now she can hear her. So that means she will start talking to her. And I've already informed my daughter that we will be either seeking a priest or some psychiatric treatment if the doll starts talking to her. But we also bought...
Whoa, that almost exploded all over me.
We also bought these We also bought these BFFAG LOL shirts, which are summing up our week. And they've got like these sequins on the shoulders. They're red. They've got like sparkly glitter letters. The BFF is in like a aqua blue. The AG is obviously in red, and LOL is in a hot pink. And Emma Maya, I got some of the mix and match shorts because this shirt is actually mine. And she had a dress on to come, so I needed some pants to go with the shirt. But I bought a shirt with the mix and match set to go with it, but it actually works with the shorts. And then Crystal bought the BFF bracelet set. So she gave Heather the beaded bracelet, and then Nameless has the purple.
You almost made me spill my pop.
Nameless.
I don't think I should be drinking right now.
Nameless.
Get the $4 day.
Nameless has this purple bracelet with the charm on it, and Emma Maya has aqua bracelet with the charm on it, but that is actually my charm, so it'll be going on one of my dolls when I get home, as well as the shirt. I don't know who it'll probably go on yet. So, oh, and Heather also painted all of their nails. So there's Emma Maya's. It's not really focusing all too well. See if we can get it. It's kind of like a aqua blue.
Sit down on the bed and Oakley's like, no.
And you wonder why I was shaking her by the head. And now, with Miss Impatient over here.
I just want to paint their nails.
And for those. I'm hanging with my homie. Okay, so for those who found it too dark in my Rainforest Cafe video to see what Nicole was doing, this is pretty much what she was doing. And the waiter comes, and he's like, what is going on?
So now we've got Miss Impatient over here with her bottle of nail polish right there.
Ready to go
to paint Mateo, Oakley, and Darth Vader's nails. And if you're wondering about the Darth Vader reference, see Crystal's Instagram. Did you post it there?
I did, yeah.
So you will figure out what we mean by Darth Vader.
I think I may have done a video clip of it too, but I'm not 100% on
that. I just took pictures.
Yeah, I took pictures too, but...
The Darth Vader will be explained either...
It's from Build-A-Bear, that's all I'm going to say.
From Instagram pictures, or if she did take a clip of it.
Yeah.
So I will be back after Miss Impatient paints baby's nails.
And I'm reaching for something in the distance, so close you can almost taste it.
I would laugh if the guy comes back on. Crystal had to call down for the front desk.
Feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you. Hi, I was...
Impatient has already finished Mateo's nails and is now working on Oakley's. What is this? Okay, this is American
She's
Girl...
excellent manicurist.
Nail polish for dolls. And it is meant for vinyl dolls.
Should I answer the door wearing my ta-ta towel?
I dare ya. Yeah.
Okay, I need to be recording that.
No.
So,
not happening.
Apparently you peel it off.
Yeah.
When you're sick of it being on your doll's fingers, it just peels off the vinyl. So it's safe for dolls, unlike real nail polish. So yeah, I will post later when her nails are done. So Oakley's hands are done, and here we go. Crystal in the door.
Hi, great, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. You too. And now I'm walking this thing
up. Now I got video of you bending over, so I got your butt.
And I didn't even know what this was called. I just said, I knocked the thing out of the thing.
That is a demonstration on how our door works.
It's a cage.
We have hit this time of day where we have all lost
it.
If anybody has questioned our sanity before, it is now not a question. Let alone this one's.
I'm going to have a shower, and I'm taking my ta-ta towel with me.
Well, maybe we need to get a ta-ta towel to make our prototype of our nut hut towel.
Alright, so for those who don't know what a ta-ta towel is, go on my Instagram, because I posted pictures of me wearing it. It's basically to take care of under boobage sweat. So Nicole had the idea of us coming up with one for men called the
Nut Hut Towel.
Oh my
okay,
gosh.
Back to fingernails.
From from boobs to nuts to nails.
We need to open a store, Crystal.
It's all bras, jock straps, or our Nut Hut towels, and do manicures and pedicures.
Wow. Okay. Help me.
You started it.
Marbles.
As Crystal is still singing in the bathroom. Yesterday they had to literally run to the bathroom.
When we were in Marshall's today, I think every one of us said I'm gonna pee.
And you notice every time we did, employees would like swarm around. Because there was one where there was two employees putting something away and one of us said, I gotta pee. Oh, we gotta stop. I gotta go to the bathroom or I'm gonna pee on the floor. And the worker came walking around the corner like, oh crap. So Oakley has her nails done. Hopefully that will zoom in and focus. Focus on the stripes. But you can kind of see it. They're the same aqua blue as the American Girls. And Mateo has his done already. And we just have Veda to do while Crystal is taking a shower and going nuts. Okay, guys. I'm going to end the vlog here. I wasn't sure there was any more before. But there really wasn't. We just ate supper. All of us took showers. And we watched some YouTube. And we laughed a lot. So this vlog, yes, I admit, is probably not the most interesting. But you'll should probably be laughing at us at some point in it. So, I hope everybody has a great evening, and it looks like Caroline is like an angel, or... There we go. No, there we go. No. The lamp behind her is like, she's a white face, and the other two you can see.
So she's an angel or a ghost?
Yeah. You take your pick. So I hope everybody has a great evening, and I will see you all tomorrow.